Good morning, students. I am your history teacher, Ms. Prabhjeet Kaur. Students, you must be aware of the pandemic disease and the tough situation we are going through. So let not waste our time and get started. I will try my level best to guide you through these learning videos. History, Standard 6, Chapter 1, The Mesopotamian Civilization. I hope you all are studying history as your subject for the first time in class 6. Because in your previous class, you had a subject called social studies, in which you had a part of history. But here, you will study history as a complete subject. So, what do you understand by the term history? History, we mean his plus story, that is story about the past or the collection of information of events of what had happened in the past. So let's get started. The Mesopotamian civilization. What do you mean by Mesopotamian? A person from Mesopotamia means, what does Mesopotamia mean? Mesopotamia means between rivers. The word civilization. What is a civilization? Civilization actually came from a Latin word, civitas. The meaning is city. Some of the important features of this civilization are people live in town and cities. Then the trade also exists between far-flung areas. Social and economic divisions existed. What does the word social mean? Social means here society. And economic division means money divisions. So here we can say that if I see in the present society, for example, we also see that everyone is not equally wealthy and stable. Some are rich and some are poor. So the division is there in the society. Economically also we see the division is there, and socially also. Next point is different religious and art forms existed. Of course, every religion has their own rituals and ceremonies to follow. In the same way, this civilization also followed different kinds of art and religious forms. Government existed to maintain law and order. As our government imposes or makes some rules and we follow them, the same way they did. Here we come to the next slide, children. Please look at page number 8 of your history book and fill in the missing letters to get the names of the city that are situated on the banks of the rivers. So, in number 1, we can see which city is situated on the bank of River Tiber. The answer is Rome. Number 2, Hudson River. The answer to which is New York. Number 3, River Seine. The answer is Paris. Number 4, River Yamuna. The answer to which is Delhi. In the present slide, we see the sites of the earliest river valley civilization. Okay, now let us see. Can you see from the given map, here all the settlements are near the rivers? If you cannot, then you can open your book and see in page number 8. There were 4 civilizations which we can see. Coming from left to right, we can see the purple one as the Egyptian civilization. The orange marked over there is Mesopotamian civilization. The one with pink is the Indus Valley civilization. And the 4th, that is the right one marked with yellow, is the Chinese civilization. So, which were the earliest civilization? From the first point, we can see Mesopotamia, Egypt, Harappa and China were the earliest in the world. Now, we have to also see that why did they come up near rivers? Why they preferred to settle near the rivers? That was because, for example, whenever you go for a rented house, what are the basic things to which we check actually? Water supply, electricity, etc. Same here described in this point. In order to meet their sufficient water requirements, they went near the rivers. In the second point, we see that of course the people could grow more crops. And why? Because the land over there was quite fertile to do so. Third was transportation also was taken into consideration when settlements took place. So the rivers served as means of transport. This civilization, that is River Valley Civilization, was also known as Bronze Age Civilization because people used bronze to make tools and implements. The picture related to it is given above. You can have a look. In this slide, we learn about the centers of civilization. By about 2500 BCE, that is before Common Era. Children, you need to learn all these four valleys by heart. So the first one is the Valley of Tigris and Euphrates, that is in Mesopotamia, known as modern Iraq. Number two, the Nile Valley in Egypt. Number three, the Indus Valley in the Indian subcontinent. And the last one is the Wanghuo Valley in China. So these were the four centers of civilization. So let's start with the topic, the Mesopotamian civilization. Mesopotamia actually is the land between the Tigris and the Euphrates rivers, and it is also called the cradle of civilization. Why it is called cradle of civilization? Because it is between the rivers, that is Tigris and Euphrates. And here, children, we can see a map which is also given in page number 9. You all can have a look at it. It is Hammurabi's empire. Now, you must be wondering who is Hammurabi. Hammurabi is actually, he was actually a Babylonian king. His records of law were found in Mesopotamia. And children, you can see red dots are there which indicate ancient sites. And with the black dot, they are the modern city. And the present international boundaries are represented with a black line. So, what is ancient site? Ancient site is actually those sites which occurred in the time long past. So, here you can also see some regions which included where Sumer, Akkad, Babylonia and Assyria. In this slide, we'll see the sources of the Mesopotamian civilization. Now children, what is source? Sources actually are the proofs or evidence. So here we see the archaeological sources. What are archaeological sources? The sources which are related to science and research are known as archaeological sources. Under that, the first point is Ziggurat at Ur. Ur is actually an ancient city in Mesopotamia. And what is a ziggurat? Here you can see on the right hand side, a picture is there of ziggurat. A ziggurat is a tower shaped structure with a temple on top. Ziggurats were not places for public worship, as people believed it to be dwelling places of God. And it also looked similar to a pyramid. In the second point, we see the seals. What are seals? Seals are stamps used to impress a design, which you can see in the second picture. Design is given on the top. So, these are the stamps which used to impress the design of a soft substance such as a wax. Now we come to the literary sources. What are literary sources actually? Literary sources related to literature, which includes any information regarding religion, culture, etc. Under literary source we see number one, the Epic of Gilgamesh. Here, the Epic of Gilgamesh, you can see a picture given over here of Gilgamesh. The Epic of Gilgamesh is an epic poem in which Gilgamesh was a hero. From ancient Mesopotamia, this poem is often regarded as the earliest surviving great work of literature, and it is also the second oldest religious text. Let us have a look at the origin of the Mesopotamian civilization. Around 3000 BCE, that is before Common Era, the citizens developed under Sumerians. It was also known as world's first civilization. So, which civilization is known as the world's first civilization? The answer to it will be the Mesopotamian civilization. And it developed under Sumerians. The Mesopotamian cities. Let us have a look at the points. The ancient cities such as Eridu, Kish, Uruk, Lagash and Ur have been excavated. What is the meaning of excavated? The meaning of excavated is removed. Since Ur was the biggest city, it was divided into three parts. Which were the three parts? The sacred area. The sacred area actually consisted a tower, which was also known as ziggurat. The third part is the walled city on a mount. Walled city and the outer town were used for the residential area. And the last was the outer town. And it was also built with mud bricks of different sizes. Under Mesopotamian civilization come social classes. The social classes comprised of three different classes. Number one, upper class, which comprised of priests, high officials, and scribes. Who are scribes? The writers were also called scribes. In number two, we come across middle class. Middle class are the farmers, artisans, and traders. Number three, we come across lower class. Lower class were the bottom class. That is, slaves were at the bottom of the social ladder. One thing here is to note, that is point to note, in a family, boys were sent to school, but the girls learned cooking and other household work. Women were not treated equal to men. Like nowadays, in each and every field, we see the girl child rising up, but in ancient times, they were made to do the household work, whereas the boys were sent to school. This showed that the girls or the women were not treated equal to men. Coming up to the last point of today's class is religion. The Mesopotamians worshipped the different forces of nature. They also believed that Marduk created the world after defeating a monster. Who was Marduk? Marduk was also a Babylonian god. Here on the top right hand side corner you can see the picture of Marduk. Each city had its own god. Means they worshipped several gods. Different gods were there. Ziggurat was dedicated to the god by building his temple on top. In that Ziggurat, priests also performed ceremonies. Mesopotamians also believed in life after death. Here you can see a picture related to life after death. The Mesopotamians believed that there is a life after death. Why? Because many graves contained the articles of daily use which people believed that they would need or the dead would need in their afterlife. So students, here we have completed half of our lesson. Hope you all got my points. Read the chapter thoroughly and complete the assignments. Number A, fill in the blanks. Number 1, in Ur, the walled city and the outer town were dash areas. Number 2, a ziggurat had a dash on the top. Number B, answer these questions. Question number 1, what were the social classes in Mesopotamia? Question 2, how do we know that the Mesopotamians believed in life after death? Number C, right, true or false? Number 1, each Mesopotamian city had its own god. Number 2, the Mesopotamian civilization was an early river valley civilization. So, children, you need to complete the given assignments in your history classwork notebooks. Have a good day.